Good morning, guys. Happy Tuesday morning. Today we are filming for the drive with me in the morning. And we got a lot to talk about today. So that better not just film a drive with me because my face right now because I have my work shirt on. So yesterday morning, like 9 o'clock, Esther was a home invasion that turned into a car chase or carjacking that turned into a 4-hour drive home. Not for me, from home. So if you guys don't know, my mom works in Southwest Portland, so she has to take I-5 to get home. Well, about, I want to say, like, I think it was, like, by the bridge where the street took place, what I can't see. So, there was a car shooting, or a cop shooting. It's all over it. If you type in I-5 shooting or closure on the YouTube search bar, you'll find it. So anyways, it made everyone go to 205. However, there is another way to get to Vancouver besides going 205. Because when that happens, 205 is a hot mess and you're gonna get stuck for a longer time. Well, so my mom went that way. Anyways, long story short, it's hilarious to me that Republicans are saying it's Democrats' fault and they have taken action. Well, here's the problem with that. Every time that we try to get a gun reform, Republicans throw a damn fucking tantrum. I'm sorry, but they do. And it's really annoying that Republicans want to act like this, saying, oh, there should be reform. Right now, to present day, schools aren't safe. There has been so many school shootings lately. The last one happened, say, a week ago in Oxford. I don't remember the state, but it happened on the east side of the United States. When is it going to be enough? When are we going to stand up and say, this is not right, we need to figure something out? There needs to be action instead of all this, oh, our thoughts and prayers are with you. When is that enough? Never. There are families that are losing their loved ones because they're not doing. So, that's my word of voice. Anyways, back to the drive. This morning we got a little chase. Channel before, you know, I got injured a couple of years ago in March when I drove down to, or drove over to Umatilla, and they had a ton of snow, and I ended up in the ditch. And long story short, when I went to go try to push my mom's car out of the ditch, I fell into my mom's trunk, and I heard a big pop in my shoulder, thinking it was just my wrist. Oh no, that was my shoulder popping, and it hurt really bad. So I had to turn off my brakes, because I can't see anyways, because of the stupid fog. And I had to have a video for this week, so I'm trying to get back into filming, you guys. It's been really hard. Sometimes I can't see nothing, so hold on. Sometimes it's harder to get back into filming, and then other times it's not. So yeah, that's the fun of this drive, is I can't see the light swap. There was one time driving up here, like, you could not even see the road because the fog was so bad. Thank goodness we have these reflector lights on it, because we get hit with fog a lot and it makes it hard. I've never had before. So for those that don't know, I am really lazy. I eat lunch in my car and a lot of fun stuff. And so by the end of the week, if I don't take it out, I go get gas on Mondays. Well, the lady that I had taken out household trash, which I was like, no, this is all from my car. Like, legit, I eat in my car. So usually by that time, I have like a ton of garbage because I'm lazy and I don't take it out. Well, I think what her issue was that she couldn't tell that it was garbage in my car because I had already bagged it when I left it, or a couple of days ago. So I just been sleeping in my car, and I was too lazy just to take it out, because usually if it's like a bigger bag, I'll take it and put it in my household trash can. So like that's the thing, is that's what I do. But I can say that I don't like messes and whatnot. I didn't want to have it in the car for another day. Well, I'm not gonna just throw it away at work and been totally fine. So why is it not raining if my windshield wipers were still on? I mean, it is raining, but it's not really heavily raining, and the sky likes to rain. So if you're wondering why I do it through here, like I have my lens on, one, it's a lot safer for me because I did get hit from right here, which by the way, I need to film an update for that because there's been some updates on that. So I'll have to film an update. Actually, I could always just update it on here and call it good. So I got an email from the guy that was also involved in the accident, from his lawyer, saying that they were going to sue me for his cuts and scrapes. And I was like, well, good luck on that, because honestly, truly, I could sue you for him for the damages to my car, and wouldn't stand a chance. Because what happened is, when the cops ruled it his fault, not mine, his fault, because I was coming down the road, like, you guys have seen it, I go down this road a lot. Sometimes I'll go a different way, sometimes I'll go this way. It just so happened, like, today I went this way, which is because I was supposed to go the other way, but I didn't want to follow the guy that had his emergency lights on. Whatnot. And the funny thing is, so not only did I have damages to my car, I had to pay for a rental car completely out of pocket because I did not have rental coverage, apparently. Which would have meant my rental company would have paid for it. And so, by the way, I hate that car. I'm just gonna put that out there. I hate that car. Thank you. money, and I was stressed out because it's like, that's a big part of my check, and I have bills and all that fun stuff. Well, luckily for me, my dad let me skip March rental payment because I had to pay to get my car fixed and all that, because at that point, I was like, I don't trust that this could turn into worse, because what happened is he had hit the side of my car, so my tire rim had popped off, like it was hanging by a thread, and it was not safe at all. But anyways, we'll go into that update in another video. We're almost to Chase. It's 6:25. But then yeah, my car gets really hot. My car can't make up its mind. Thank you. this, right? I don't like going to Dutch really early, so it just makes it hard. Not to mention that I have to turn off the roaming because how I pay for Dutch is through their app. Well, the problem is it's on my phone and my phone's gonna be hyped. So I will see you guys for another drive with me later on.